Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with my second look at a Tenkai Knights set. Previously, I looked at a set that had a few of the little miniature figures, the regular sized ones. Now, this one is a Titan set. So this is Tenkai Titan Bravenwolf, set number 13001. Comes with one figure, one Titan figure. Yep, bunch of parts, some of them very small little detail things, and some of them relatively big. Got his wing pieces here, obviously. Here's the head piece. Looks like it's gonna fit on a little bit differently than the small heads do. But the most important and interesting things here are the main Titan body brick, and then you've got a weapon brick included here. So this is, I'm just gonna share my very first experience with these, since I have no familiarity with them, once again. I'm just gonna see how this all works out. I'm just gonna follow exactly what they have in the instructions that I have by my side. And yeah, here we go. Stuff opens up. This is kind of a cool idea, how you have bricks that can actually kind of transform. What they don't show you in the instructions is that you have to push the face in. You see the face inside there, kind of push that in. That allows the body to drop down in front, leaving the face behind. Here come the feet. Big staple feet. Now we're getting down to the real shape of the core body here. So that's a Tenkai Titan skeleton, basically. The brick fully transformed. That's what it looks like. You see it's got a huge base to make sure that it stays stable. Got a bunch of places to attach things to, studs all the way around it. Got a little bit of straight forward and back articulation there if you want to use it, or it'll just snap into place. These are on ball joints. Elbows are not. They're just single axis. Similar for the legs. Ball joints for the thighs, the upper thighs at the hips, and then just regular. These are actually slightly ratcheted. That's a good thing. At the knees, same thing at the elbows. It's a little bit less apparent there. And then ball joints in the feet to make sure that you can always put this down completely flat on the ground. I'll go ahead and finish putting this together and then have a look at the completed model. Okay, this is a weapon brick, so I'm gonna slow down for that and have a look at how this works out. You can see it's in the shape of a brick. You can use it for building, but the way it's supposed to be used is you open all this up, and I'm just gonna follow, again, the instructions. This part's a little bit tricky. You gotta get your nail in there. There we go. Comes out like a pocket knife. Flip this over, and there should be a spot where, yes, the handle comes out, and then these little guards will flip out like so. So now I've just turned a brick into a sword, and that just goes straight up into his hand. So there is Tenkai Titan Bravenwolf. I gotta say, he looks pretty epic from this angle. Let's go ahead and rotate it around a little bit so you can see from some other angles. Love that large sword, transparent red, looks really good. Lots of nice, cool molding going on with his shield over here. These spikes that come out look pretty cool. The helmet definitely looks very good. It's got his wings on the back, of course, and these are, they can slightly be angled. There's not a whole lot of, no, they can be angled all the way up to there. Okay, that's not too bad. That's not too bad at all. The head, unfortunately, doesn't look like it can go back much farther than that, and it kind of wants to lean forward. In my experience here, the holders for the wings kind of get in the way there. Looking at it from the back, I definitely like the transparent there. It looks like energy, you know? Looks really good. So it looks good from most angles. Now, let's talk about playability, right? What kind of poses can you get out of this guy, or out of the Titans in general? There will be some limitations to this one in particular based on what's, you know, attached versus what some of the other figures have, but most of the Titans will generally have the same overall amount of range of motion, so this can... Well, the arm gets up a little bit. Let's see how this one works on this side with the sword there. Open this up, just trying to get the arms up as far. It's not too bad, not too bad. And I can turn this out. Ah, it's starting to fall off. Things are really hitting each other quite a bit. The wings were hitting back here on the back of the shoulder. The spire just barely fits in there. I really want this to be successful, but it's a little bit tough to get some poses out of this thing. Getting the sword, okay, let me just zoom this out so you can see the sword can come up above his head. Gosh, that sword is huge, look at that. So that's good, that's a very important ability to have for the toy, for the figure. Stand him up a little bit better there. The shield, the way the shield is attached, it's just kind of attached to the back of his hand, which kind of makes sense. But let's see if we can bring it across his front. Let's see, maybe I can get it under here. Not really. This is not going to come across the front, so he can't really protect himself from the front. The best you can do is go to a 90 degree angle on the elbow and then put it up to the side and then kind of look from the side. So he's going to be, let's see if this will turn. Doesn't really turn. The head doesn't turn. What? Come on. Oh man, that's a disappointment. There's a little bit of range of motion there, but it's not really going to turn so that you can be looking across the shield. You know, that's something you want to see. You can turn the feet. That works great. They've got ball joints in them. You've got apparently plenty of range of motion for the legs for any kind of normal sort of pose. You can kind of get him down. Let's see if I can get this, bring this back and have him leaning forward into it a little bit. That's good. The legs, I think, work out well. I think that's well done. The arm with the weapon, he can get pretty much every kind of pose that you want with the weapon. Turn this up and, see, that got in the way again. This part flipped off or got knocked off. So you just have to kind of watch out for things. You can kind of cross it across there. You know, these are important things, right? For play is setting up the poses, the really cool poses. Turn this to the side a little bit. You can kind of get that across his body now. Looks pretty cool, but stability is actually fine. You know, you can easily put the feet where they need to be, but he can't really look up. If he's leaning down, he's not able to look up. He's not able to turn his head very much, and he's not able to move his shield across his body. So I think there's a lot of limitation to the articulation for something that has so many joints in it. They end up making it such a bulky character with all the stuff on the outside that it's not as cool to actually play with as it should be. I think it looks really good. It looks accurate to the show, the TV show. I think it just looks cool in general for fans of this style of figure. I think it's a great presentation. They also give you a few extra parts with this one, so you can change out a couple of things or add other stuff. You get these red pieces are not used. It's these ones that are used on the sides here. They use them in dark gray, but you can swap those out or put these on at the ends. I think this would actually be a good place to just put them right now. Put them at the ends of these little spires on his, put them that way. Yeah, that works out. And you also get a couple of extra white tiles with this one. Just plain white, put those wherever you want. You know, you can put them on the shoulders or I guess one can fit here. There's different stuff that you can do. You know, a little bit of customizability, not a whole lot there, but extra stuff is free stuff and it's always appreciated. Overall, I think this is a much cooler figure. The Titan mode is a cooler setup than the original ones. I'm sad that you don't that you're not able to take the original brick of the mini size one, fold that up and use it as a brick to make the Titan version. You know, I think that would have made a lot more sense if there was an inclusion there, so you really upgrade rather than having to just buy an entirely new figure. I can understand buying an entirely new figure, but not being able to use them together doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. So this is really a completely separate skeleton. Good looking, playability is limited, unfortunately. This was $12 or $13 at Toys R Us. I've been told that the prices will come down a little bit. I think that the price is reasonable for the parts that you get and the complexity. But again, I just wish that the playability was a little bit better. But that's it. Those are my honest original first thoughts on the Titan mode, Tenkai Knights Titans. This one was Bravenwolf. They're all going to have the same basic shape, but different things added on that will change their range of motion a little bit from one to the next. Thank you for watching. Hope that that was informative for you, or at least a little bit entertaining. I enjoyed it. It was a cool new experience for me, and I will be checking out some more other different types of Tenkai Knights sets. I've done little ones, I've done a Titan, now I'll try some of the vehicle type stuff also. So stay tuned, watch for that, and you can find all of my updates as soon as they become available at JANGBRiCKS.com. Talk to you again soon.